All right, what's up, everyone? This is Rudy from Drinks in a Movie podcast, and I'm back with my seasonal co-host, Carissa. Today, we're doing another short little video episode talking about our five horror movie Halloween season recommendations. I'm once again chowing down on this Old Forester Single Barrel Barrel Proof from Canyon City Liquor in Azusa. Go check them out, pick up a bottle. This is one of my favorite Old Forester expressions to date. So, let's start with yours. What's your first recommendation?
Okay, so my number five is Event Horizon. I don't know if anybody
I've never seen that.
Oh my gosh,
that's the one with Sam Neill?
Yes, and Lawrence Fishburne. So it's funny.
Haunted house in space?
Basically, I'm like, it's if Hellraiser meets a space odyssey. It's okay. Wild. It's okay. Very body horror. It's okay. Very like, it's fun, it's trippy. I love that movie
yeah.
So much. And I think that not enough people, because they don't know what it is, not a lot of people have seen it. You should watch it. I think you'd love it too.
I need to. It's been on my list for a while, but I think now that you're bringing it up, I'll try to see it sooner than later.
You should. How about yours?
All right, I'm gonna start up with a newer movie from 2024, In a Violent Nature.
Okay.
But I know you didn't really care for it. For those of you who haven't seen it, it's essentially a play on like a first person view of say like the Friday the 13th story, like zombie killer comes back to life, puts on a mask, and is stalking some teens that are camping out in the woods. And there's a little backstory with his parents and all that stuff. It's great.
That was actually cute that they did all this stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty neat because it just told from the killer's perspective, this kind of zombie monster, Jason Voorhees type killer that's walking around the woods. And it's in third person perspective, maybe a little bit of first person, I don't remember. Yeah. And I just thought it was a good idea. It is a slow burn movie. I know you kind of were whatever about it when you first saw it, but I think it's worth checking out. I think it was a risky move and I appreciate that. And it has one of the coolest kills I've ever seen. So when it does get into the special effects, time to kill people in really creative ways.
The person I was with was what did you bring me to see? This is disgusting. And I sat there, I was a little stoned. I was like, I don't know what I'm watching.
It is awesome. It's one of the best kills I've ever
seen. It was pretty crazy.
Yeah, even if you don't like the rest of the movie, you've got to appreciate that part. But yeah, so number four, what you got?
All right, so my number four would probably be Pearl, going back to the movies. Sure. I loved Pearl. I think it's so fun. I think it's so pretty. I love Mia Goth. I love it. I think that's a movie that everybody should kind of see this year. Cause I mean, Maxine came out and I think going back and seeing that one's probably my favorite out of the trilogy.
Pearl?
Yeah, for you?
All right, for me, I'm gonna go with Inferno by Dario Argento from 1980. So this one I just saw for the first time at a midnight screening fairly recently, maybe 4 months ago now. It's actually been a while. But I really dug it. Great cinematography. Moments of crazy musical score, weird kind of storyline where it jumps from one character who you think's the main character, but then it falls another person and then they get whacked and it's like, oh, now I guess the movie's about this guy kind of thing. But I thoroughly enjoyed it. I love the aesthetic, I love the color. I think I'd actually prefer it over Suspiria. And this is part of that trilogy, what they call the Three Mothers trilogy. From Dario Argento. This would be the second one after Suspiria. So yeah, Inferno, check it out if you've never seen it.
All right, my number three. This one is a lesser known, it's a found footage movie. It's called The Bay. Have you seen it?
No, I feel like I've heard of it.
You might have. So I don't think it got a theatrical release. It's very but I love that. I love found footage and I love it 2012, old school, 12 years ago. Oh my God, 12 years ago. Crazy, but I love this movie. The effects in it are pretty good. And then just the way they do it, it's like a small town. Everybody kind of disappears. What happened? All this footage is found. And it basically shows what happened in the bay and how everybody got.
Yeah. Okay. Are we interested in seeing that one?
It's really good. All right. I would love to do a movie like this.
Okay.
Yeah.
The Bay from 2012. I'll have to check that out.
Mm-hmm. I'll send it to you.
All right, cool. So up next for me, I'm actually gonna go with Hatchet for the Honeymoon. This is from 1970. This is Mario Bava, who also shot it, I believe. This is one of the movies he shot as well. So Hatchet for the Honeymoon. It's about this guy who is like a bridal. He makes bridal dresses or whatever. And so these women come in to try the dresses and he murders them, and he like narrates the movie too, so it's all from like his perspective. So he like murders these women to try and unlock this trauma that he had as a kid. So he's like doing that so he can try and remember this crazy thing that happened to him when he was young. And there's this whole like other plot with like his wife is kind of a bitch and he's kind of a bitch to her. And it goes
a place. I've never heard of that. I'm gonna look that up.
Honeymoon by Mario Bava. So, you know, I've been like in the Mario Bava hole the last several 100%. Months. 100%. So, this one, again, more cool colors, cool suspense. The character, even though he's crazy, is like kind of charming. So yeah, check it out.
I guess my number two, and just because VHS Beyond, a new VHS movie came out this year.
Yeah.
My favorite.
Is that one about aliens? Like alien shit?
Kind of. All of them are about aliens, but then so there's five segments in there, but I think three of them, and then the two others, not so much, but one of them was really wild and fun. But my favorite VHS was VHS 2. Mm-hmm. 2012, in my opinion, they had the best segments out of any of the VHS, just like the effects, everything. Because I know like VHS, low budget, they made a lot of money. This one, they got a little bit more money towards it. So if you do see any of the VHSs, VHS 2 or VHS 80, I don't know. I like them all. I love them all.
I still haven't seen any of them, so I got to do that. So I know.
We should do a VHS thing.
Okay.
Rudy.
Okay.
I love me some found footage.
Yeah, I do got to check it out for sure. Up next for me, I'm gonna go with Eyes Without a Face from 1960, French film. I forgot the name of the director, but I love this movie. This was one of the movies that my friend Malia and I covered in the very first season of the podcast, like the first kind of series of October like horror movies. Love this one. If you haven't seen it, go find it. It's actually on Criterion Collection. It is about this plastic surgeon dude, and he has a daughter that got her face destroyed in like a car accident that I think was his fault, if I remember correctly. So him and his, not his wife, but their helper, who was, I forgot the actress's name, but she was also in Suspiria. They kidnap women. And so what he's trying to do is a face transplant. So he'll like murder these women and like take their faces and try to like use it on his daughter because she's deformed. And it's like a really great, just a really great kind of, or I guess this, I feel like it's kind of horror. Maybe it would fall like the horror adjacent category, probably depending on where you draw the line. But it does have this great like plastic surgery scene where you're all in. This is pre-Saw, obviously, like pre all that stuff where they're just, the camera's there and they're showing the whole like procedure.
Really?
Yeah,
and it's so weird when you
see really
that.
Great effects. Yeah, and I love seeing that because you're watching, you know, 1960 black and white French film. So when I'm watching it, I was not expecting it. And you know, the quality and like the black and white photography like really add a layer of like creepiness to it. You know,
100%.
That I think if it was in color and stuff, you wouldn't.
But the authenticity of maybe black and white, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It being like, ooh.
Yeah, but it's a really, that's like the big standout scene in the movie. But yeah, that is well worth checking out if you're not squeamish and okay with like, I'm not gonna say it's gory, but you know, I feel like the surgery scene still holds up really well by today's standards, in my opinion.
All right, my last one for this list. This is one I think everybody should watch this year. Strange Darlings.
Ah, hell yeah.
I put that on there. I was like, dude, we went to go see that. And I was like, this movie, what the heck? It was just so wild. It was just not what I was expecting. I loved it. I think that it's a fantastic movie. I think it's so fun. And I think it's one movie, like, I don't know, because I know it was like a little popular, then it kind of fizzled out, like everybody kind of stopped talking because I think like The Substance came. Everyone started talking about The Substance and like the next big thing, you know? But this one I feel like is gonna make its place. It's just gonna take a little bit of time. But yeah, Willa Fitzgerald was fantastic. That's her name, Willa Fitzgerald,
yeah.
Was fantastic, and the actor was great too.
Yeah, Kyle Gallner.
But yeah, that was my number one. I was like, ooh, everybody should go see this movie this year.
Yeah, I was gonna put that in a top spot, but I guess I was thinking like the horror adjacent category again.
Yeah.
I'll make that an honorable mention for me, and I said this in the other episode. Agree 100%, for me, one of the best movies of 2024 by far.
Yeah.
For sure. Not many movies I've seen three times in theaters this year. And, you know, modest budget, modest amount of characters, nice runtime, gets you in, gets you out, keeps you guessing the whole way through.
Yeah.
A wonderful cinematography on 35 millimeter film. Wonderful colors, just wonderful music, amazing soundtrack.
Yeah.
Amazing original soundtrack, great acting, everything about it. By far one of the best movies. So yeah, honorable mention for me. Yeah, go watch it. And like you said, you know, it kind of fizzled out, I think, on streaming. I think this movie will blow up. I hope it does. If
I hope it
doesn't.
It does too.
And you know, I think like decades ago, this would have been the one that found its life on like VHS or DVD.
Yeah.
You know, like after the fact, like, oh, everyone's like, this is the movie everyone talks about and that
yeah.
everyone remembers from the year 2024, you know? But my number one, I'm gonna say this, I had to put this on the list, Night of Living Dead, George A. Romero, 1968. One of the greatest movies of all time. Not one of the greatest horror movies, for me, one of the greatest movies of all time. The godfather of the whole zombie genre, at least as we know it today.
Yes.
Amazing performance and just, you know, Dwayne Jones as Ben. Obviously, there's the kind of cultural reasons mm-hmm. for that as well, but, and the fact that it's another like low budget indie movie, just kind of friends getting together because they wanted to make a movie and wanted to be in the film industry, and they all chipped in and got this thing done with friends from the town in Pennsylvania. And it's like a real inspiration and just shows a lot of that like attitude and spirit and changed the game for the horror genre
yeah.
and ratings and all that.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolute masterpiece.
Mike can make extras do on set in
yeah.
eight.
yeah. All right, so yeah, that's a wrap on this one. I hope you get a chance to check out some of these recommendations before the Halloween season is over.
Yes.
And if you have any ideas for any other videos like this we could do, leave a comment and then maybe we'll do some more of this stuff.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's a wrap. Cheers.
Cheers.